Coming to you live from Bravo Performing Arts, this is Avantura Power, a podcast brought to you by Brook students for Brook students.
Today you will hear many of our segments, including comics and cover-ups, Josh's epic talk show, Yep, That Trio, and the Unknown Variety.
If you like what you hear today, be sure to subscribe to us on the YouTube for the latest Hour to Empower episodes.
Okay, everybody, enjoy the show!
When he got on a plane in Portland, Oregon last night, he was just another passenger who gave his name as...
Hello, people, and welcome back to Comics and Cover-Ups. Today, I'll be investigating the strange and bizarre disappearance of a man known as Dan Cooper. So get your tinfoil hats ready, because we are about to take flight. On the afternoon of November 24th, 1971, a man who called himself Dan Cooper used cash to buy a one-way ticket to Seattle. Cooper was a quiet man looking to be in his 40s. He was also wearing a business suit. While waiting for the plane to take off, he ordered a bourbon and a soda. After 3 p.m., he handed a note to one of the stewardesses. She didn't read it immediately, but when she started to walk away, Cooper told her that he had a bomb. I'm assuming that the note said that he had a bomb on it, because he was trying not to freak anybody out by saying that he had a bomb. But then when she walks away, he's supposed to be excuse me, I have a bomb. Hello. Cooper told her that he wanted her to sit next to him, and when she did, he opened his briefcase that he had next to him, and inside of it was a bomb. He told her his demands, and she went to the cockpit to alert the pilots to the situation. Cooper's demands were quite simple. He wanted 4 parachutes, $200,000 in $20 bills inside of a knapsack. A knapsack? Knapsack, no. And enough fuel to get him from Seattle to New Mexico. He said he wanted it by 5 p.m., and if they, quote, tried any funny stuff, he would, quote, do the job. They later landed in Seattle, and Cooper's demands were met. He told the pilots to fly to New Mexico at an altitude of 10,000 feet and no faster than 190 miles per hour. At this heightened speed, he would be able to open the staircase on the plane without immediately being sucked into the night sky. Cooper started to put on his parachute and told the stewardess to go back to the cockpit. This interaction would be the last time Cooper would ever be seen. At 7:42 p.m., a light flashed which told the pilots that the staircase had been opened, and later, at 8:12, the plane wobbled. When the plane landed, they didn't see Cooper anywhere, and they soon realized that the plane shaking was Cooper jumping out of it and descending into the stormy skies. The manhunt quickly started as thousands of police officers and military troops searched the area. Even the CIA searched by deploying a super-secret spy plane to help, but they found nothing indicating that he had even been there. All they found were his tie and a couple of cigar butts on the plane. Immediately after, dozens of people reported the story and it became front page news. A typo in one of the first newspapers created had called him D.B. Cooper, which gave him the new name. The FBI soon decided that Cooper had most likely died, but it still didn't explain how there was never a body found and how they didn't even find a parachute or the money. It took 7 years before any more evidence besides what they already found turned up. In 1978, a group of hunters found an instruction card showing how to lower the staircase that matched the exact kind of plane Cooper hijacked. Only 2 years later, an 8-year-old boy found $6,000 in $20 bills on the beach that he was playing on. But the strange part was that it was 20 miles away from Cooper's suspected drop zone. Most people would suspect that when he landed, he dropped the money into the river and it floated to the beach 20 miles away. Normally, that would have made perfect sense. Normally. Except the river flowed the opposite way. Someone had to have buried it, which implies something very dark. Cooper survived. There have been many suspects over the years, but to me, one stands out from the rest. His name is Dwayne Webber, and to me, he's the most likely person to be Cooper. But before Dwayne died, he said to his wife, "I have a secret to tell you. I'm Dan Cooper." After hearing this, his wife started to recall various things that seemed a little strange. For example, Dwayne apparently had nightmares about, quote, leaving his fingerprints on the plane, and had a knee injury that he claimed from jumping out of a plane. There was even a book on Cooper that had Dwayne's handwriting emojis. She even found a plane ticket from the exact same airline that was hijacked, and they traveled to where the money was found by that boy. So yeah, to me, he's the most likely suspect. He even fits the physical appearance, and it just makes the most sense. And so that's it. This is an incredibly interesting case to talk about, especially because of how influential it was. I mean, this made such an impact that a device called the Cooper Vane was installed in the planes to keep the staircase shut during the flights. So that is unfortunately all I have the time for to talk about today. But don't worry, this may seem like the end, but Auto and Power will be returning in 2022, most likely in January or February. So I'm gonna be working on a bunch of episodes, and so is everybody else in between that time. We are so excited. I will be seeing you in 2022 for another comic or cover-up. Bye!
Jingle bell, jingle bell, jingle bell rock. Jingle bells swing and jingle bells ring. Snowing and blowing up bushels of fun. Now the jingle hop has begun.
Hello, it is I, Jingle Jangle, owner of Jangle Incorporated, the best and biggest jingle bell selling company in the country. We produce quality jingle bells only sold during the holiday season. And we are here to tell you how amazing they are so that you will buy them. Here are some of our customer reviews.
These jingle bells are terrible. Don't buy them.
Oh, I'll teach you not to buy them, you little... Jangle Incorporated, a company you can rely on.
Hello, I'm Josh, and this is my talk show, Josh's Epik Talk Show. And I think I forgot my script. Cut. Okay, so you're probably wondering what that was. That was, well, my intro, but messed up. And you're probably confused on why I don't have a guest, and why I'm just here alone, just doing a behind the scenes, because this is behind the scenes. Well, I guess, I don't know, I just want to do behind the scenes, because I just want to answer some questions no one has probably thought of, and just say some stuff, and I'm mainly doing behind the scenes. It's the last, well, actually, okay. This segment's into the first question that I just want to answer is, why am I doing behind the scenes? Well, I'm doing behind the scenes because, well, this is the last episode of Josh's Epik Talk Show, and I guess you could technically say I'm talking to myself for my talk show, but yeah, it's just the last episode, so I just mainly wanted to answer some questions and just say some stuff about the show. So my second question that you guys are not wondering, and probably no one's wondered, is, well, is this scripted? And it's a very, I guess you could say easy, but also it's a very niche, I guess, question. So I wouldn't say niche is the right way to word it, but I guess it's a very complicated, but also easy at the same time question, because what I actually have scripted is mainly my intro, outro, and four, like, main questions that I don't change, but I just use them as, like, a guideline for what I want to ask. And, well, I guess it's just none of else is scripted. It's just all really, well, I guess the intro and outro are not one-shot takes, but the, I guess, like, the actual recording part is a one-shot take, and then that's it. You just don't do any more of it, but I don't know. It's been nice since this is the last episode of Josh's Epic Talk Show. I guess I could do podcasting again, but I probably would do something else because, well, I don't know. I just want to spice stuff up, as you say it. But I just want to do behind the scenes. And, well, also, this segues into something else I want to kind of talk about to everyone listening as well. Every episode that we've submitted, I think it's like 4 or something. By the time you're hearing, I think it's 4, maybe. I'm pretty sure 4. And you're listening to the 5th. Well, I've had an episode out every single time. And I'm the only person. I think I'm pretty much the only person that's had an episode every single time. It's not the fact. And it's like, you would think, oh, I just have to talk to someone, and yes, but no, because I have to find someone, and, well, when there's only, like, 5-6 people in the club, and some days only, like, 4 and 3, it's very hard to actually find a new person to do. Like, it's been, like, just finding an original person, and, like, all the editing, I've had to do it, like, some of it during school, like during actual class time once I finish like my work, because just it's been, I don't know, I guess you could say it's just been a bit hard having to like do all the recording every single like week or like deadline, because I guess it's not every episode's every week. By the time I'm recording this, 4th episode is not out yet, and well, they're editing and they're almost releasing it, but the 5th episode, but I'm recording this for the 5th episode, the last one, and a lot of people, when you hear this 5th episode, it's gonna be holiday special, and, well, I think I'm just gonna do, like, behind the scenes as a holiday special, but also, mainly one thing is, when I'm actually recording this, the main reason I'm doing behind the scenes is, well, mainly, but the day I'm recording this, there's, like, only, like, 3 other people here, and I've interviewed one of them, and they're too extremely busy getting their holiday things up, so I had no one to record, so I guess I'm doing behind the scenes now. Well, and I guess, yeah, it's, I don't know what to talk about. Well, I guess I could say that. Well, I don't know. But since I've not planned any of this really, because first shot take, I guess. So, well, I guess I could say, I could like continue Josh's Epic Talk Show, but I don't know. I really just want to do something else. I kind of just want to keep it, like, keep doing it, like, or not keep doing it, but like change something else and do something new that's just original and, well, I guess you could say new. But also another question that you guys are probably not thinking is, well, like, how, like, I don't know, like, how long does it actually take to get, like, a real episode out for us? Or, like, how much work we have to do? And, well, it's a lot of work because, well, you do editing, like I said, like, editing and then actually recording and getting people to record. But it's not just me. I'm actually going to give a bit of behind the scenes for, like, the rest of, like, I guess you can say, like, the podcast a bit, but, like, everyone has to record. Well, not everyone. It's mainly if you want to record and you have time by the deadline, you can. Meaning that's why Hour to Empower isn't an hour sometimes. But even though it's not an hour sometimes, I guess it's, well, it's nice being able to record and, well, being able to talk what I want and talk with other people. And, well, I don't know, I feel it's just, I don't know how I feel about recording this, but, and actually uploading this, but I guess, I don't know. It's my talk show. I guess I can. But, I don't know. I don't know if there's really much to talk about. Like, it's very, I guess, like, podcasting itself. Like, actually making the podcast. Like, I've learned a lot from this. And you could just say this talk show is literally just me just, like, going on and on about this. But it is. It is just me going on and on about this, but it's true, and, well, it's true, and, well, I don't know. I guess I've learned a lot from this club, and I might continue to do it, because right now, when I'm recording this, it's, like, close to winter break, and, well, and the club ends on winter break, but does resume after, but I'm probably, if I do join, just not do talk show anymore and do, well, something else, as I said. Oh, and yes, I am fully aware there's a lot of background noise. I'm definitely aware there's background noise, but, like, I'm recording at school, like, after school, and there's, like, in a hallway, so there's gonna be noise and background noise, but you know, all I've said, even though it's around, like, a minute long, this is a minute long, it's been nice doing talk show, and maybe I'll probably continue doing podcasting, but, like, different thing, and, well, it's been really nice, like I said, doing it, and, well, it's kind of sad making my last episode. I guess I'll just have to move on, and I know I don't have to, but, like, I don't know, it's been hard, like I've said multiple times, it's been hard just finding someone to record, so I think I'm gonna move on to something new, and, well, for one last time, bye!
Tyler with Yep That's Real, a segment all about weird news. Today, we'll be having a holiday segment, so we're doing
Tyler's Top 10 Facts,
Winter Edition. So let's get started. Number 1. If you leave a little snack of cookies and milk for Santa to keep him filled on his journey, thank the Dutch. On December 6th, St. Nicholas Day is celebrated. Dutch children leave him food and drink before they go to bed as a trade for gifts. Now, the tradition has spread all over the world.
Number 2.
Christmas wasn't always celebrated on December 25th. When people celebrate Christmas, they are actually celebrating the birth of Jesus. But his actual birthday is lost in time. There's no mention of December 25th in the Bible, and many historians say he was really born in the spring.
Number 3.
While we're talking about the calendar, December wasn't even always the 12th month. I know it sounds crazy, but it used to be the 10th month until 135 BCE. If you look very closely, you can see dec at the beginning of the word. If you didn't know already, dec means 10 in Latin. Number 4. I'm sure you've heard of the song 12 Days of Christmas. And if you're thinking about getting your true love all those gifts, you might want to think again. Overall, buying all of the gifts in the song would cost you $179,454. The most expensive gift of all is the seventh day with seven swans of swimming, which would cost you a whopping $13,125. Number 5. Do you want to ship something to Santa but you don't know his zip code? Well, if you live in Canada, you know what it is. If you don't know what it is, the code is H0H0H0. Some people say it's not real, but I'll get back to you on that. A reminder that we're halfway through. Don't leave yet. We still have so many fun facts to go. Number 6. When people say no two snowflakes are alike, they are very wrong. A scientist at the National Center of Atmospheric Research in Boulder, Colorado, actually found the first ever two identical snow crystals in 1988. Snowflake twins, that's amazing. But you never knew it could snow in the desert. Snow in the northern Sahara is unusual but not unprecedented. January 22nd, 2021 is the fourth time in 42 years the Sahara has seen snow, with previous occasions in 1979, 2016, and 2018. Snow in the desert? Snow way! Number 8. Jingle Bells is a beloved Christmas carol, or should I say Thanksgiving carol. In 1857, James Lord Pierpont published Jingle Bells as a Thanksgiving song. Slay what? Yep, it's true. Its original name was One Horse Open Sleigh, but it was reprinted and changed to Jingle Bells. Number 9. If you celebrate Hanukkah, you probably know what a menorah is. But do you know about the one in Washington, D.C. that is 30 feet tall? The national menorah lighting is viewed by tens of millions of people on site and from around the world by news broadcasting and other media. Number 10. Have you met Olympio? If you have, you would know that she is a 122 feet snow person made out of 13 million pounds of snow in Bethel, Maine. She was the tallest snow person in the world until last year when her record was broken by Reese's, an Austrian snow person coming in at 125 feet, just a 3 feet difference from Olympio. So that's all, folks. Hope you enjoy this segment of Yep, That's Real, your most trusted segment for weird news. Have a jolly winter break. Goodbye.
This is your unknown rider, rewriting a bit of Charles Dickens's classic tale, A Christmas Carol. But I couldn't make it all this, because otherwise I'd get copyrighted and you wouldn't be listening to this. So, let's make Scrooge a bit meaner, shall we? I hope you enjoy it. Happy holidays.
Slash this! Well, you don't need to eat. You didn't waste money. Bye-bye. Christmas break. Firing you!
Did I get to go home for Christmas break?
Nope.
Firewood in the fireplace?
No. Firewood costs a lot of money these days. Later that night.
Your business partner locked in chains, locked up for all the wrong things I've done.
I don't care.
Yeah, I know.
What? I can't read that.
You're not reading anything.
Suck, Scrooge!
No, why?
I remember that.
This is not.
But, doesn't matter. As long as I have money now, nothing else matters.
Hey there, Scrooge, it's me, the host of Christmas Present. Why don't you check out your friend Bob Cratchit's house? He's having a Christmas party with his crippled son, Tiny Tim.
Oh, why does that matter to me?
So I can show you the true meaning of Christmas and so that you stop being a greedy little jerk.
Perfect.
Must learn the true meaning of Christmas. Other you die, be hated by everyone, and Tiny Tim will die.
I don't care. Bye, Maya. That's fine. I don't want to learn a lesson. I don't want to learn a lesson. It's Christmas. Well, that was A Christmas Carol written by me, kind of, sort of. So I hope you enjoy it. Happy holidays from podcasting. Unknown Writer, out.
This was Alan to Empower, a podcast by Brook students for Brook students. We are your essential source for news, comedy, interviews, and more.
Hour to Empower is brought to you by Brookle Performing Arts and Gwendolyn Brooks Middle School.
For more information on how you can be a part of our shows, clubs, and classes offered by Bravo, please go to bravoperformingarts.org.
And if you want, subscribe to us on YouTube for the latest episodes of Hour to Empower.
Thank you for listening
to the Hour to Empower podcast. We are so thankful to whatever small group of people decided to click on our videos and listen to our podcasts. We're so thankful, and we hope that you will all listen to us, and maybe even more people listen to us next year in 2022, because we are coming back. This may seem like the end, but it is not. We are going to be back in 2022 to continue season 2. So get ready for that, because it's going to be awesome.